Pipes Alive. That was easy. Thanks so much. Thanks so much for being here on this beautiful day. It's much too nice to be in here, and so I'm glad you've chosen to come here and listen to amazing organ music. Play fast. This is our Pipes Alive organ series as part of the Music at the Red Door concert series here at St. John's, and we have some great events coming up, and we're about to release our events for next season, so you have to come back and hear what those are going to be. But coming up right after Easter, we have a chamber music event with Suzanne Bona, who's the host of Sunday Baroque on NPR, and we'll be here playing flute with wonderful pianist Brenda Miller. So that should be a really wonderful Saturday event that you can come and enjoy, as well as our next Evensong, which will feature the choir of Trinity Church on the Green in New Haven, which is one of the premier choirs that sings in the Anglican tradition, men and boys. And so that will be a remarkable evening, and so come and enjoy that as well. Two of my friends are playing the upcoming Pipes Alive concerts. Jackson Merrill from Trinity Church down the street is next month, and the following month is the inimitable, did I say that word right? Krista Rakic, who's a great friend and our artist in residence here, will be back on a little break from Oberlin to play on our series, and we look forward to that as well. So I'm gonna play the organ for you now. Hope you enjoy it. I'm starting with two pieces by Bach. Bach, of course, the undisputed master of all music. No music we have today would exist without his masterwork and all that he put into music and inspired. Yes, thank you, Meg, for pointing. He is up there, the bottom right-hand corner of that window. And so at home here in the church, watching over all the mistakes I might make. And this first Prelude and Fugue in C minor is a rather short compared to some of the super long ones that he wrote. And it is written in an early part of his career. Early part of his, probably in his teens or 20s. And you can kind of tell that he's showing off a little bit with the pedal solo that opens the thing up. And there are a couple of moments where you're looking at the music and thinking, yeah, that's kind of just filler a little bit. He's trying to get from here to there and doesn't quite know how to make the connection yet. And it's still masterful and amazing to hear. And then following that, I'm gonna play the beautiful chorale prelude, Schmücke, dich, deck thyself, my soul with gladness. And it's a beautiful little dance with a ornamented, decorated theme that you'll get to hear within that. So here we go, Bach.
Thank you.
So the next piece is pretty cool. I get to play a piece of music just written for the first time. And I'm delighted to say that the composer is with us today, Francesco Blackmore, who's a senior at, where are you at? Central Connecticut State University. That's what I thought. I just wanted to make sure I said it right. Central Connecticut State, where he's a composition major and also an organist. And he wrote this piece of music, and Meg Smith, one of my wonderful students, brought it to for me to sight read through, and I said, oh, this is great. I would love to play it. And so we tweaked it together and worked it out a little bit, and here it is today for you. It's called Prelude, the Tonality of Time, and it's got three little sections, but it all runs together in one experience. So the opening is a sunrise. You'll hear that and experience the sun coming through the windows and the way it does delightfully in this room. There's a very active middle of the day. There's sort of a little Baroque improvisatory thing that happens. And then at the end, you'll hear triumph that the day was successful. So here's to hoping that the piece will be played successfully, but we'll celebrate that at the end.
Thank you.
He'll be up here accepting questions after it's over. If you'd like to analyze the score with him, he'd be more than happy to do so. finally, I share two greatly contrasting pieces for you. To a Wild Rose, Sorbet for the ears, and then John Cook Fanfare. During Lent here at St. John's, we retire the big trumpets, the giant reeds, and so this was an excuse for me to use them during Lent. Because it's a concert, it's not a service, I can do it. So this piece features the two solo trumpets, the party horns, if you want to call them that, in the organ, and there are two. There's the trumpet en chamade, which you'll hear first, which is that horizontal thing that will hit you in the back of the head back there. And then the trumpet harmonique is in the front of the organ, is actually significantly louder, but it is buried a little bit by where it's located. So I get to hear that super loud. I don't hear that thing at all. So it'll be very interesting for you to enjoy it, and I just kind of have to trust that you will. So have fun. Thank you.